Dear students, we want to discuss some important function which are in your syllabus. This function is known as absolute function or modulus function. How you define modulus function? See particular example. We read it, mod of 2 is equal to 2. Mod of minus 5 is equal to 5. What does it mean? We see that whatever the value of the domain, range will be positive. So if domain is real number, the range will be positive real number. It is clear. So domain of the function is set of real number. And range is positive real number. So now, question is how you define the function. A function y is equal to fx, that is mod x. The value of mod x is x if x greater than 0 and is equal to 0 if x is equal to 0. And minus x if x less than 0. This is very important. I just told you the value of modulus function is always negative. But what do you observe? It comes with minus sign. But observe it minutely. X is negative here. So minus of minus x. Positive. So minus. Suppose x is minus 1. Then minus minus plus. X is minus 2. Then minus minus plus. X is minus 3. Then minus minus plus. In this way we define modulus function. So, now question is how will you draw the graph? It is the graph, just we have drawn the graph of identity function. But in identity function, y is equal to x. But here, mod x, that is y is equal to x when x greater than 0. Means when it is positive. But when it is 0, it is 0. It is 0. So, here, this will be the graph of x greater than 0. Graph of x greater than 0. And this will be the graph of x less than 0. This will be the graph of, second graph is x less than 0. So, and third graph is, it means 0 is not included. It means 0 is not included. But here, this is black. So, we have taken 0, x is equal to 0, in this arm. Here, x is 0 in this arm. So, that's why the modulus function is defined either fx is equal to x if x greater than 0 and fx is equal to minus x if x is equal to 0, and this will be linked either with this branch or this branch. So in the definition, in some book, it is written, fx is equal to mod x is equal to x if x greater than equal to 0 and minus x less than 0. It is not written. And in some book, it is written, fx is equal to x if x greater than 0 and fx is equal to minus x if x less than equal to 0. So you may put either the sign of equality with greater than 0 or less than 0. So, in this way, we will draw the graph of the function. I hope you have understood. Now, I want to draw the graph of signum function. Signum function. And signum function is, in short, written SGN. SGN, not SIGN. SGN. signum function. So, I want to discuss what is signum function. It is a very, very important function. So, the function defined by this rule, fx is equal to mod x by x. Try to understand, mod x by x. When x is not equal to 0, then the value of function is mod x by x. And when it is 0, then it is 0, not 0 by 0. Keep in your mind, the function defined by y is equal to fx is equal to mod x by x when x is not equal to 0. And when x is 0, it is 0, not 0 by 0. 0 by 0 is undefined. We cannot indeterminate form 0 by 0. It is known as signum function. And it is denoted by S, G, and X. Signum function. Now, how will you define? After removal of the modulus function, I want to remove the modulus function. Then what do you observe? Then, when X greater than 0, then the value is 1, suppose 2, 2 by 2. Suppose it is 3, 3 by 3. And suppose it is minus 3, then minus 3 by 3, minus 1. So if you remove the modulus sign, what do we observe? We observe that the value of mod x by x is equal to 1. And value of mod x by x is equal to minus 1 when it is less than 0. So what do you observe? It is very interesting. When the value is 0, it is not 0 by 0 form. Because it is defined separately, the value of signum function is 0 at the point 0, not 0 by 0. So you take your mind. You should be careful while solving the problem, yeah, while sketching the graph of signum function. Now, we draw the